The Class 93 is a new Stadler-built tri-mode locomotive with a bobo-bogey configuration, which basically means it has two bogies, each with two axles, and that each axle is powered by its own motor. The 85-ton locomotive can produce a continuous tractive effort of 230 kilonewtons and has a power rating of 4 megawatts, or 5,360 horsepower. So the Class 93 is not quite as powerful as a Class 92, but more powerful than a Class 90. The locomotive is capable of travelling at up to 110 miles per hour or 177 kilometers per hour, and crucially is able to travel on electrified and non-electrified lines. To operate on non-electrified lines, the Class 93 is fitted with a 12-cylinder Stage 5 Caterpillar C32 engine, and in addition has two 400 kilowatt lithium titanate oxide batteries. When running on the engines, the Loco has a maximum power rating of 1205 horsepower or 900 kilowatts, so is significantly less powerful than modern diesel locomotives such as the Class 66 or Class 68. However, the diesel engines and batteries are designed primarily for the last mile, and the Loco should still be able to pull sizeable loads when running in diesel mode. When I visited the Class 93 stand at Rail Live, I was told the Loco could pull a trailing weight of around 1500 to 1600 tonnes in diesel mode, and if true, it would be more than powerful enough to pull a lengthy intermodal consist. The two 400 kilowatt batteries fitted to the Loco can also provide a boost whilst under the wires and whilst in diesel mode, pushing the power to up to 4.6 kilowatts or 6,160 horsepower when drawing current from the overhead lines and batteries, or 1,740 horsepower, 1,300 kilowatts in diesel plus battery mode. The batteries can be recharged from the overhead 25 kV lines and the diesel engines, and in addition can store power generated during regenerative braking. The batteries can only be used for short periods, up to around 20 minutes or so, depending on the load, so will be used primarily to provide a short boost if needed, or potentially for shunting operations. The Class 93 has a top speed of 110 miles per hour, which could mean it could be used for high-speed freight services or to pull passenger trains. However, the top speed for freight services would be limited by the wagons, with most intermodal wagons in the UK limited to around 75 miles per hour. But if the locos are successful, then it may provide the impetus needed for freight companies to invest in newer wagons, which are capable of higher speeds. It's not yet known where the locos will operate, and the owner, Rail Operations Group, is remaining tight-lipped at the moment. But there have been several interested parties, and I wouldn't be surprised if we see the locos hauling intermodal trains on the West or East Coast main lines. Currently, ROG has 10 Class 93s on order, but there is an option to purchase more should there be sufficient demand. The locos are currently undergoing testing, with trials to fully test the 93's capabilities expected to begin in September. I just want to give a big shout out and say thank you to Simon Trains, who kindly let me use the clips he captured of the Loco on test. If you haven't already, I would urge you to check out his rather excellent railway vlogs, to which there is a link in the description.